delivery. Your bag of cat has arrived.
Oh my gosh. Hey.
He like, is that one of his eyes? Like,
hey, cat.
You want to
get back in the bag?
Go back in the bag. That's what you want. That's what you learn from this, is you want more bag time. Well, we can make that. My bike.
He and his bike.
Oh, this like never happens.
Never ever happens.
Yeah, he's been playing with the cat all morning, and now he's not ready to go. We're finally rolling out. It's a pretty nice day, and we're actually. You have the key?
It's behind his house.
Okay. Well, John here, who's already nicely hosted us for a couple days, offered his lake house. And granted, it's only 130 miles down the line, so that's, you know, where it's like half of where we wanted to be
yesterday.
2 days ago, day before yesterday. In the Hamptons, someone offered to let us stay in their place, and we didn't take it, and we said we wouldn't pass on it again. And you know, we don't really have a timeline. You can always book it back for Halloween. You can always book it down Florida.
Your idea of what's going on with that camera?
I'm just generally not aware of what's going on with that, but. We need a goddamn film crew. There's something inside you. It's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy. But you're still the same. There's something inside you.
So as you can see, this is starting to fade, and the strippers were noticing. They're like, "Wait a minute, that's not a real tattoo." It's like, you know, a couple days ago they thought it was real and it looked kind of cool, and they're like, "That's a stick-on tattoo," and like just respect disappearing. So,
oh man, what's it gonna be?
Yes, sweet.
That's actually kind of cool.
Yeah, it's going on my neck.
Oh, God. This is what our trip has devolved into.
Woo!
It's our bounty of tattoos. So, we actually had so many that we have duplicates. So,
and someone's gonna get these sweet stickers on their bike. We haven't determined yet.
Oh yeah, forgot to show. Well, so I've been keeping track of total trip mileage, and George has been keeping track of fuel mileage. So, as you can see, we're at, this is the ninth time it's rolled over, so we're at 9990. We've got exactly 10 miles until we hit 10,000 miles, which is, you know, just another number. But, you know, it's important. It's a nice round number. You know, we have 10 fingers, 10 toes, yeah. Moving up in order of magnitude.
Really, I'm gonna have to go put on another one right now.
Why is that? Because we have so many?
Just we have so fucking many. I'm gonna throw away Tears of a Clown. This one is just there's nothing. What is that sexy to someone? What does that even mean? That's the single worst tattoo we've gotten in any machine in America.
So anyways, we our good friend John Hans clued us into the fact that he had a beach house down on the Gulf Shores in Alabama.
Makes it sound like he just let us know it was there.
Yeah. Well, I don't think he expected us, considering we kept acting like we were in a rush, I don't think he expected us to take him up on the offer, but he had offered to, you know, let us come check out his beach house, which, upon, you know, further reflection, we realized it would be stupid not to.
Okay. We're in our house. The house is called Terra by the Sea. Kind of cool. George has prepared us two types of gruel.
Two types of bachelor's cob paste.
So these little meat pellets are
sautéed jalapeno Vienna sausages.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm actually kind of looking forward to this.
I'm actually kind of disappointed. I'm pretty sure they're gonna suck.
No, we're quickly running out of fake tattoos to put on. So we've sort of decided that I'm gonna keep this awesome guy for getting back to Raleigh to, you know, really wow the people that are important to me.
the dragon one?
Yeah, yeah, the like the hairy
like
dragon
has been harvesting skulls from a graveyard.
He had better things to do.
And
we have this variety of skulls, which, you know, if you think about it,
getting a skull tattoo on your neck, like a flying slash flaming skull and hearts with roses, it's pretty edgy. I mean, no one would ever hire you for a job again.
Yeah,
I mean,
completely unemployable.
Yeah.
Look at that scary motherfucker. What are you doing?
I'm trying to use this mouthwash bottle I found as alcohol to take off this old one. Because nothing is like less respectable than like, you know, having one that's still coming off before you put a new
one
on.
That's huge. That's, you know, hugely.
Huge.
This land is too shitty for old men. We actually already know where this is going, but we wanted to show America that, you know, we're in the Gulf Coast, which we were led to believe was rife with once beautiful white sands beaches that are now covered in oil. We've been on the Gulf Coast.
How long ago was it? Was it like April that the explosion happened?
Is that what it was?
Pumping out, you know, like a small amount of oil, and then they upped it to like a bigger amount of oil, like an obscene amount of oil. That's a really soft sand.
So I guess we wanted to establish is, I guess by the end of this,
at least two beaches.
No, we were in Louisiana and Gulfport. We've been driving along the coast for a while now. Now we're going through Florida. I think if we don't see any oil by Key West, I think you and I can declare the Gulf Coast pristine.
You know, as good as it was before the storm.
As good as it was before. BP. The Gulf Coast, not as good.
Satisfactory.
What if they had to clean up the Jersey Shore and so they just like, you know, left all the hypodermic needle?
We need to get
one before.
So whoever cleaned up these beaches to the Jersey Shore to scrape up all the, you know, scum.
And medical waste.
We're having to walk through sand for this, so I hope it was worth it.
Yeah, under the scope of human tragedy and suffering, this is right up there with.
I mean, there's, you know, Holocaust, Darfur, us driving through Michigan,
Trail of Tears,
walking through sand, Baton Death March,
Hindenburg, the Titanic.
Just to be clear, us walking through sand is worth than.
We sleep in a swamp one night, so I mean, that's easily worse than the Hindenburg.
I get, those people, you know, they were burned alive, but we have bug bites all over our face for days.
Yeah.
No one, I mean, we're feeling extremely self-conscious.
So we've been,
we were just wondering
where the Samsung was. And George, I was like, dude, I don't have it in mine. I think I gave it to you. And he's like, I don't remember putting it in my pack. So he's frantically going through his stuff. And George, why don't you show us where the camera is? Right there. And it's been that way for about 100, like 70 miles.
Yeah, about 70 miles. You know, these are pretty stable. There's not any reason to be.
Holy shit. Oh, go, dude. You are just out to destroy the Samsung, is what
I mean,
it is.
I mean, I don't know that we ever showed, you know, the damage. Camera, the damage that, like,
you
there's
know. There's like a chunk missing, and this thing's a little wobbles.
I want to destroy this camera.
Keep it away from
me. Holy shit.
So Ian is smartphoning away, just shaking the tree of people we potentially know in the area. So we're definitely racking our brains to think of how, what 6 degrees of separation if you used it. So we have bug spray this time, so hopefully we won't get our faces lit up with mosquito bites again. But I mean, according to the map, it's pretty much swampland, you know, for the entire state of Florida. So if we don't find a place indoors, it's gonna be fun.
My hands aren't that dirty, are they? I'm trying for the first time a BMW Anonymous book.
I appreciate it. Thanks. I hope your girl gets better.
I think his wife or girl or girlfriend is sick.
Hi, I found your number in the BMW Anonymous book. Okay. All right. Well, anyways, thanks for answering. And well, they're all answering so far. We got one, two down. Another BDR.
Much to our pleasure. The BMW Anonymous book worked out very well. We met up with a very nice couple who let us into our home and made us a sandwich and gave us some beer and showed us to, I am assuming, what were their son's beds.
Two Oompa Loompa beds.
Yeah.
Sorry we didn't film, but you know, we've called strangers and asked them to put us up in their house. It seemed rude to put a camera in their face.
Here in Key West, we may or may not have any indication that we arrived here because I got
right
off
in the middle of Key West right now.
I got off on my helmet cam and was apparently like filming the opposite of everything I wanted. I'm not exactly sure for how long. Yeah, so we're gonna try to find a bar, of course. But we're grabbing, you know, our book. We're gonna start calling people, see if we can find a place to stay tonight. Ian's found a cat.
Definitely, remember, this reminds, it's like a Myrtle Beach with, where the average age is plus 20 years. And,
yeah.
And the average income is...
Plus, is positive.
Is positive.
There's fucking beach. Chickens, too. I've also seen running around in the street. That is, I mean, it seems like a nice enough place. I mean, beach towns, see one beach town, see them all. We're on a mission. I have to get my uncle a hat from Margaritaville.
Oh, yeah.
So we'll try to find that.
It should be a giant tourist trap.
Giant tourist trap. So we're probably going to try to get in and get out. My family went there when we came here.
Well, that's what tourists do.
Yeah.
Traveled 11,000 miles to come to Myrtle Beach for old people. And gospel.
I guess that's the problem, is I don't really feel like I've earned this kind of relaxation with Gluttony.
Absolutely not.
I mean, this entire trip, I guess I feel like I've under-struggled. You know? On any given day, I've drank more, eaten more, and slept more comfortably than I would have in my normal life. So, where's the struggle, America?
Once again, combined with incredible kindness of strangers, our friend John picked us up in Gulfport, Mississippi. He put us in touch with some of his friends in St. Augustine, and they just have an incredible place. The sun is setting, so we wanted to grab the camera.
There's a man's business card right there.
For twins.
I guess, you know, putting doctor sounds pretty cool, but how about putting captain on your business card?
This is cooler.
This is way cooler.
Captain. Way cooler.
You know, you want to go to Belize, you want some anesthesia, you want to be captain of a 100-ton boat.
You go to Key West, everybody stand around and say, captain. You know, you go to Harvard, everybody, doctor.
Doctor.
You know, whatever's going
no,
on.
No, captain's way cooler than doctor.
I think so.
Yeah.
You can do more. I'd rather captain a boat than, you know, give medicine to old women.
Like, if there's anything I'm afraid of, it's like, I want to travel around, I want to do all this cool stuff, but one thing I'm afraid of is, you know, winding up 30 or 40 and being alone. And then, like, you know, at that point, all the other women have gone and married
up. Alone? What are you worried about?
Well, I mean...
You don't leave alone.
We've met some people...
There's a fair amount of time in there that you can be with someone.
But you've met some people like John a little bit about women.
A little bit.
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
And that scares us a little bit.
But that's the thing I'm saying.
They can fuck me up. You know, I mean, my first wife, I didn't like her, but she got pregnant. Thank you for all the fucked my life up pretty good. It cost me a lot of money. And I mean, you know, when I left, it's like, after I left, I got this credit card with $10,000 limit. She went and bought $10,000 worth of fucking shoes. You know, I had to pay for that.
I mean, the
right.
So it totally. It seems to me. I mean, you were saying this to us the other night. Like, you know, I've done all this stuff, but I got my girls. I got my wife here. How the fuck did you pull that off? You know, you got to see the world. You went on these cool adventures, and somehow you ended up. You know, later on down the line, having not missed the bus on finding a you know a good woman and having a good life.
For me, huh?
It sounds like a good thing.
God will. Yes. You know, I mean, I was lucky.
Is there? I mean, it wasn't anything you ever planned on.
Maybe God gave me something nice in life, you know?
How'd you work? Do you think it's just karma? You were a good enough guy for long enough and that came around? Do you ever have a plan? Or you ever worry that you thought, shit, you know, I'm running around all over Caribbean. Maybe one day I'll end up alone? Or you never worried about it? Just figured it would play itself out.
I never worried about being alone. I mean, like alone without a woman?
Yeah.
That's never been a problem, really. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's always been women. But with the right woman, the whole deal, you know, being with the right woman.
There's plenty of wrong women out there.
Yeah, a lot of them. I'll tell you, man.